Hello friends, today I am going to tell you how to establish a SQL connection in ASP.NET. So let's start. Let's flip to the Visual Studio and open to the Visual Studio run as administrator. It will take some time. Wait for the Visual Studio. This is the home page of the Visual Studio. Go to the file, new, and project. Let's select the Visual C Sharp, ASP.NET, and name your application. Let's write the SQL connection. Here is our database name DB employees, and I want to obtain it in the grid view control in ASP.NET. So let's establish a connection. For first of all, we have to create a connection string. For the connection string, let's see a string CS is equal to quotes. Yes. First of all, we have to think about the server. Let's call your server, that is data source, is equal to, if you are using your own machine, then you have to dot right the dot. It will to the local host and then name of your database. So my database name is DB employees. Let's give the DB employees and then integrated connection. For open the SQL connection, first of all we have to import the package using system dot data dot SQL client. Then here SQL connection here, your connection string, then the SQL command. For the SQL command, type SQL command cmd equal to new SQL command. Write your query here. So let's, we want to execute that this query. Let's copy and paste it here on the connection form. View control. Let's now call the grid view data source to grid view one dot data data source equal to, we want to execute the cmd command, then cmd dot for the execution and execute reader. And then we have to bind the data to grid view or data bind. It will open the connection and execute the command and retrieve the data from the database and show on the grid view control. So let's run and what is going to happen, what will happen. established connection in SQL connection in SQL.NET. So let's remember, after the executing the command, it will skip these two lines because of the exception and which left the connection open. So we have to close the connection after execution. So we have to use the using statements here. Again.